kid.
Oh, you turned all this on. What did y'all cut off? Oh, you hear it?
The speakers, you just ain't got it off the speaker.
Yeah. You want it in the speaker?
Yeah.
Round up, no need for awards, just give us applause. When we do what we do, all in one accord. Henny on the camera, Mac on the board. Mook handle the biz, the rest truly yours. We in it for the culture as well as the love. When the team moving sync, make it do what it does. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. On your mark, get set, get ready. Let's go, Remix them radio. If they don't, let them know. This is Remix them radio, where culture, comedy, music, and movies collide. Every Saturday, 8 to 10, tune in, come check us out. We gonna do what we do, hope y'all enjoy. Saucy baby, let's do it.
Yeah, we back. With another session, MXM Radio, Mook the Guard. We got Henny in the building.
Yo.
We got Les on the board.
Much love.
Everybody's here. Saucy's here. Mech's here. We got Malik the Guard in the building.
Peace.
We got Irfin doing some videos for us today. Everybody's here.
Okay,
how y'all doing, fellas? How y'all doing?
Everything good, man. How was your weekend?
It was alright. But I wanna yeah. Continue off of the last show, since you know this is a special situation. Malik,
peace to the God.
What's going on, brother?
All praises due.
Okay,
brother.
Okay.
All praises due. Always.
I said, why not continue the show that y'all had going on? Cause y'all was talking some real good stuff. Let's spin it over into ours a little bit. Let's keep building. Cause I like where y'all was going.
We have to. This is the time that people need to be awoken with facts.
Okay.
No more opinions, no more beliefs.
Right.
You have to go into the archives. People need to know that to get the facts, you have to go into, especially what's going on this continent, mm-hmm. Library of Congress will tell you everything. They got all of the documents that you need
right.
to know what's going on and what's been implemented.
The Library of Congress. That's a special place. Yeah,
absolutely.
It's a special place. A lot of stuff get done over there.
A lot of stuff is in there.
Yeah.
They ain't got a lot done. Of records. A lot of stuff gets done. Yes, yes.
Done too.
And
yeah,
that goes to show you that.
Yeah.
And what's funny, unfortunately, is that the people don't even know that everything that's being done, your ancestors taught the ones that's doing it against you.
Exactly.
So, you know, hey, let's let's go. Let's
kick
get
back
in.
And build today.
Yes, let's,
you know what I'm saying?
Build.
It's a special night.
Let's
MXM
rebuild
Radio.
The empire.
I think we on a building session tonight, y'all.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? We gonna build tonight all the way.
I feel the building session.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
Les,
yeah.
Let me hear something to warm us up for the fellas. MXM Radio, y'all.
Got 75 going on in here tonight.
I'm a 70s baby. Let's do it.
What's going on here?
That's real music time. That's real music. Let's get it. That's when you have to be able to write, read, and play instruments.
Okay.
You have to be able to read music, write music, play instruments. You have to have a skill set.
Let me know when that song finishes, we'll get into it.
He's out locked out, right?
He's locked out, right? He got the key in his hand.
You said,
let me put the late young blood with the yellow sweatshirt on.
Yes,
he's right here, bro.
MXM Radio, we in the building. We're about to kick some knowledge. We got the two Mooks and
They're gonna kick their
two more leaks,
Two kings.
The two kings. My bad. Two Maliks. Two Maliks. Peace to the gods.
Peace, peace.
Two Maliks, my bad. Two Maliks.
No
two
worries.
Maliks.
No worries.
I thought we were gonna have some fun today, y'all.
let's elevate. You know,
what we gonna take there? This the unexpected cipher. Side. Yeah, this the unexpected side.
This is the cipher, the way it's
the side they was waiting for. Now they're so thirsty for me to talk this shit.
Let's hit them upside the head with it, you know?
Let's talk about it.
Oh, no, we're gonna have some fun.
Cause you know I got my 2 cents.
And we ain't talking nothing but facts. They can look everything we about to say up. Go research what I'm about to tell y'all.
So y'all get your VCRs.
Get your tape deck.
Get your tape deck ready.
Get your pen and pads ready so you can take notes.
Old school.
Then you can do like the brother, like the guy said, do research.
You know, that's a fact.
Look it up.
Oh, the Magnificent. Oh, I love that.
They don't do pen and pads anymore. They got memo pads in your phone. So you just say what you got to say. They go memo it.
That's the problem. You got an apparatus that's controlling the information. Because that phone, you don't think it's governed?
Okay, hold up. Before we get deep into it,
right.
Let's stick to the criteria.
Okay, what you got?
We don't want to give it too much. It's only 880 something. Okay.
All right.
So, Walter, you're in last place, brother.
Horrible.
That's what it is. I got a victory.
See,
at any given moment,
I want to prove
this shit point. Can switch.
You're right.
Time out. Well, we on countdown. It's like 5 weeks left.
I don't even know.
Yeah,
I'm
going
to be honest with you. Yo, I'm a Savannah State gone. Fan.
I've been new that for
the keep
Brooklyn.
The
season is going, though. But at the end of the day, I'm not mad about it. That's going to give us a good draft pick. That's what you
think's the bigger picture.
You know, like, I've been saying this since earlier. Like, yo.
Like an ownership.
Okay. You think the bigger picture? I ain't mad at you.
I'm not mad, dog. I'm not mad. Because at the end of the day, but how like the Giants?
How are the Smurfs in first
place?
Yeah,
the midgets and everybody.
Come on, though.
How are the Smurfs in first place? And what's going on with their roster? The dude is hurt. I know Saquon is
back,
out, right?
Back shit, it's
dogs. It's an injury here.
What's up with
half my squad injured?
Danny Dimes is good.
Then my man Lamar got the cold.
Yeah, we
got
to get some Giants representation up here. Like, no.
It's so big.
I don't think nobody rep the Giants.
He's in the same boat I'm in. I know, but I don't want to.
I'm up north. I don't know nothing about down there in Jersey.
Ain't mad at you. Ain't mad at
Listen,
you,
that's fake New York, like, you know what I'm saying? It's Jersey to me.
I'm about to say that's not New York, period. That's why I keep saying they New Jersey.
New Jersey Jets and
that's
New
why I don't
Jersey
fuck with
Giants.
The Jets.
Right.
I don't fuck with the Jets.
Because that's New Jersey, right. I feel you. I'm with you on that.
And you know what the people say? That's Giants. It's closer than Dallas.
So that makes Buffalo is the real only New York
team. I've been saying that since day one, dog.
See, now I got an official Buffalo fan with me.
I'm not a fan.
Buffalo's the only New York team.
But that's the only team from New York.
Yeah.
That's football.
Thank you. Football guy.
Allegedly.
Oh.
Malik. So, do you have a favorite football team, bro?
I don't.
Don't say the Steelers, please.
Nah, I don't. Because they 11-0.
What it is football is actually a very, you know, interesting sport. I look at how the game is played. Old school. I'm older, so I look at how the game was played.
When
you could really hit tackle it. It showed your endurance. Okay. It showed your abilities, your strengths, and your perseverance.
Some real skill set.
So if you're talking, I love the Ravens because that cat, Lamar Jackson, is a beast.
I respect Lamar.
Hold it down, Lamar.
I'm mad they got my own wide receiver, but you know.
They
got Dez Bryant now.
What happened with this? All right,
they got Dez Bryant now.
I'm going to be honest with you. I fell back from following.
And we got to play them this week.
But what happened with the Steelers and the what's name game? Like, I've been seeing memes like the Steelers and the Ravens game. What happened?
Steelers won.
The Ravens lost.
Yeah,
they did.
The Steelers 11-0 from what I heard.
Oh, yeah.
First time they've been 11-0 in the history of the
franchise. Yeah.
Shots.
More fire.
Shots.
Yeah, Mecca in the corner getting shots.
You got Mecca in the back ready to snipe everybody. Talking about, you gonna stop talking about my teammate, that dog.
I'm waving over to Mecca to come over.
Mecca ain't trying to hear you because you took a football. What are you saying? Mecca ain't trying to hear you.
I thought they won.
Nah, they lost.
No disrespect, Mecca. I thought y'all won.
That 11-0 is real, dog.
Y'all still a threat.
Like, it's contender. It's still contender.
Right, like, yeah, remember, the games don't really count.
11-0 in the Corona era, right?
Yeah. That's what is real.
That's what you're saying. That's what we're talking about. Getting to the playoffs.
The NFC East has built our whole everything on that. As yeah, long as we, you get that's why we with a person what they got 4-7 and they're in first place. Yeah, that's why it's okay, because as long as you get to the playoffs,
that's when it's great with that other. Now it's like, okay, mano, you got one time. So now that's your concentration, that's your focus, that's your preparation, mm-hmm. and that's you saying I'm better than you, and we gonna make this do what it do.
Today,
mm-hmm. right now.
Ain't no other game. No. Ain't no other comeback.
Ain't no,
we try.
We don't play round robin.
Who's the best today?
Exactly. And you continue on that path all the way to that.
Because you got to go on the
field. Don't go nowhere. We got to talk about your team, too. Don't think.
After playoff, you got to go on the field.
You escaping.
Right. You have to.
After so that means you got to be perfect.
There's 16 games in the NFL.
Those are 16 practices. Mm-hmm.
Then you got to play, what, how many more games? Like another four or five?
Five.
So you got to go 21. You got to go like almost 21-0. You gotta win the first one to 21 wins. How we play ball. Yeah. First one to 21 wins.
Basically the first one to 21 wins.
Yeah. Facts. So you know, that's when it counts.
Alright, so now that we got that out the way, let's kick the knowledge of how the NFL did not bow down to this coronavirus.
Nobody.
Oh, come on, you ain't stopping.
No businessman did time out.
You're not stopping the NFL, dog. How you gonna stop the NFL?
I'm just saying, because
that's big Vegas. Vegas. Look
what
at the fights.
To buy down to?
Look at the fights.
Okay, you know how they
look at these fights.
What seasons did they stop? They stopped baseball
for a little bit.
They yeah. they halted basketball for a little
right.
bit. But I knew. I told my wife. I said, the good old boys ain't going for that.
Well, you got to remember, and I'm sure the guys know. Now sports teams are no longer sports teams. They're corporate. They're being sponsored now by corporations. So these corporations like, hold up, my stock dividends are going down. We got to get y'all back on the field. And you know, you got to get us that bread being generated. Even
it's
though
big business,
you can't. Now check out how they. This is the game, and the people don't check it out. They're saying you cannot come to the stadium to watch the games. Right?
It's a fact.
But they got more people watching from home, so they making more money because they got
television.
They got the ratings, but they got contracts with these entities
bonuses
to show
and,
these games. So they still getting paid. And then whatever they say, quote unquote, they lost, they write it off on their taxes and get that back. So again, when we start getting deep, that's why when Donald Trump showed those tax returns and people was crying, he didn't pay taxes.
He did.
He just knows how to make himself non-tax liable. Which right. everybody's supposed to be able to do.
Yep.
But people don't, have we said it, brother? People don't research and read.
At all, they don't read.
All you got to do is write the IRS and demand their manual.
What they say about private. Knowledge.
It's power.
Knowledge is power, but it's not for everybody.
Right. What's the judgment for the person that don't know?
You're on your own.
That's why they ain't telling you.
Hey. Now listen, that's the thing. They're not supposed, but the thing is, that's our ancestral energy that we already have it within our DNA. We've just been
turned off,
confused, or put into a hibernating state.
So the red or the blue pill?
Red or the blue pill. It's red or the blue pill.
Red or the blue pill, you gotta wake up.
You gotta wake up. It is, because you know.
All this is about us, y'all.
It is. It's all this, everything that's going on is about the Aboriginal people on this planet about to reclaim their throne.
It's all about.
And they're trying to hold off as long as possible so they can try to put another two or three of their generations in at least a place of they don't have to be under what they think we would do
right.
to them that some
they
of them did to us.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Like
so
yeah. you don't hold.
It's something that, you know, people got to see.
Well, we're all about love, though, so I don't even understand why they, you know, don't get our type of people.
They're scared, dog, because it's what they did to us.
But they. Okay, listen. Everybody was a slave at some time in history.
Facts.
Every people.
Okay. Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Now, what was slavery based on then compared to what they used?
Right. But still, nobody want to be nobody's slave.
That's a fact.
Because even we were made to be God's slaves. Remember that. Mm-hmm.
Facts. We were supposed to serve our creator.
So we're a slave too. And we don't want to be no slave. That's why we bucking down here now.
When you said the God slave, I was just having a conversation last night. So maybe you could help me out with
what's
this.
What's up?
Because they was talking about when you say peace to the gods, it's actually down in us.
No.
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 Brother Rock, if you listening, call in, Brother Rock. Because we are emperors.
Okay, no.
We're not gods.
Okay, hold on. You're
an emperor.
No, hold on.
An emperor is higher than a god.
No, listen. No, it's not. Listen. When you are a god, number one, let's go back to language. What's your definition of god? Let's go start right there.
Well, you talking about Greek mythology or? No.
What is the definition, G-O-D? We're going to start right there, and then I'm going to explain everything.
Tell me what you're saying, because I don't get what you're saying.
Okay, you just used the word emperor. Yeah. You can define that, right? Somebody that governs a whole bunch of people and all that. Mm-hmm. That's the definition of that word, right? Yeah. Okay, what's the definition
like the king
of
gods and, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
What's
so
the definition
god
of
is like,
God? That word.
Okay, that's what I said. Elaborate. Tell me what you...
The definition is a group of people. That word is a plural word, number one. Okay. There was no O in the original language,
facts.
If you go back and look.
Facts.
Okay, so that word God is even made up. It didn't even exist to our people.
Okay.
Church didn't exist. Mm-mm. None of these words exist.
Okay.
So, if that word God never exists, who gave it to you, number one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I'll give you an original word. It was Gad, which was a city back in the time. Mm-hmm. So you can go look it up in G-A-D. You can go look all
G-A-D.
This up.
G-A-D,
right. Okay. Remember, there's no O in the Hebrew language. So that word wouldn't exist at all. You see what I'm saying to you? So they gave you words to trick you, to throw you off your original tone, your original language, your original way you spoke.
Vibrations,
right.
Energies, and frequencies.
That's what I'm saying. So, if I know the definition of the word God is a plural word, which means these beings, that means it's a group of people.
Okay.
So if I say you're a god, of course you're a god, because you're a group of beings, of smart people, you come from that group.
Got you.
So if I'm black, yeah, I can say I'm a god all day.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what god are you? I am Emperor,
okay.
Emperor Rock, King, such and such, such and such. Everybody got their tribe, but we all under that one.
I got you.
So that's what that comes from.
I feel you.
Did that clear it up just
a little?
So all black man is God?
Yeah.
You said all group of people is God.
All black people, because we all make up God.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So, yeah, it is correct. You just got no language. When you break that language, because there was no English back then, we were speaking Arabic. We were speaking, you know what I'm saying?
Merit.
First, we got to get off King James Version of that Bible. And get away from that. Get away from Christianity.
Starting to set it off.
Let's get it.
Listen, you set it
so
off.
Hold on. Why we got to get away from the King James Version of the Bible?
What does that
King
mean?
James, all right.
What is, okay, let me ask. What does version mean?
Version means different types.
Version means interpretation.
Interpretation.
It was King James interpretation of what the scriptures, which were not written like the brother said, like the guy said, was written in
Hebrew.
Ancient languages.
Right.
That had to be deciphered. And because they couldn't decipher, they had to add
my people don't speak like art thou in the hills.
They had to add words to make the definition come to life what they wanted it to
them.
Be.
Right.
So if, at the time, you said king, this person was a ruler over the people. He wanted them to fear him. So he said, I'm telling you what this means, and you have to take my word for it. Now, if you're going back in the King James Version, like the guy said, and I'm not saying anything disrespectful, Europeans are our children. We all children of the Creator.
King James?
King James, but the people were illiterate back then. The only ones that could read back then were the priests. The king couldn't even read. Yet, they interpreted to the king to say, this is what it means.
Still,
the king,
it was
king
a privilege James? To read?
Yeah. They couldn't read back then.
That's crazy.
They
what,
couldn't
they,
read.
So, is King
so they
James
read, they read,
but king,
read
but see,
it to the
king.
King.
Excuse me?
So they read it to the king.
They
and
interpreted
that
and recited
gonna,
to the king.
I'm going to give it to y'all in depth. King James is William Shakespeare.
Mm-hmm.
These are all plays. Look at the Bible, y'all. Y'all read the Bible. Everybody.
So let me pull the mic back because he's about to go. He's going in hard.
Yeah, I'm taking it there, y'all.
Yeah, okay.
Day to day.
Yes.
William Shakespeare is an author.
Facts.
Right? He puts on plays.
Facts.
Right? Okay. The Bible is based on allegory stories of different people. So when you hear somebody in church and they on that pulpit, and I'm getting into the Episcopal of Paul, I want y'all to turn to this.
Mm-hmm.
Who knows what the word Episcopal means?
Go. Hit him.
Epistle means just a letter. So that means this is just a letter from Paul that he wrote in these books of story. So every time y'all look at that damn Bible from here on out, and y'all going through all these pages, every chapter says, Episcopal of this person, Episcopal of that person, Episcopal of this person. I mean, these are all letters from people that was there back in his time. So how can that be something holy if you know these are just letters of people that wrote that just a book of stories?
Because the domination of information...
The storytelling,
but the punishment and the fear they injected into the people made them feel. So what they did, the ones who knew it was wrong, they killed them. The ones who were kind of like, I might have to accept this, and they was like, okay, then they bred everybody else just to accept. That's why they, when they say, here, just read this, they don't explain anything. Nothing is defined. Nothing is explained. They just say, here, this is what it is, and this is how it is. And the energy and emotion that they use to get you to accept it, it's just like any.
The Bible is a good hype man. You can use
any book, any one of them, because actually...
Torah, they all the same.
They
all the Quran.
Because we were not... Our ancestry, like when we was talking, our ancestry is timeless. There's no time to our existence.
In the beginning.
So, I got a question. Y'all speaking on that. The Hebrew Israelites, what would you say about them because of, you know, they believe in some of the things I was saying. Like, I'll be watching some of the things you're saying, I could relate back to by going on YouTube and watch Hebrew Israelites. They touch on some of those subjects.
A lot of our people touch on all them subjects, but at the same time, they still don't know who they are as far as explaining certain things. They're in the right direction. We all going to the same place.
Okay.
But even look at their name, Hebrew Israelite.
You were saying Hebrews earlier, so.
You see what I'm saying to you?
Yeah, so they're Hebrew Jews.
But Hebrew and Jews, the same. Hebrew and Israelite, the same thing.
That's like oxymoron, like African American.
You calling yourself a Hebrew Israelite, that's the same thing. Really.
Because the original, the original outline.
Okay.
Was Ethiopian.
Exactly.
So how do you go from the Ethiopian to
Hebrew? Let me get some to some music. We're going to get back at it because I know these people, we could be here forever.
Going down, y'all. Tune in. 8 to 10.
Tell them, man. Yeah. Yeah, bring the video right about now. Yeah? I'm just trying to put y'all on. Everything that's good to you, I good for you.
You do this!
You know what I heard the other day? Since you did at TY House.
Yo, remember I had Son of Sam, everybody up there with y'all? I'm gonna put something together. I'm gonna need you to quarterback it, bro. Alright? I'm gonna put something together. Something like Case Lady did. But my original people, my people. But I'm not saying. Eight balls each. But you gotta give me a fire beat. Something. It's gonna be mostly younger people anyway.
touch of tanzanine. Love to have kids with her. I gotta make a Danny's queen. It's death to his part. And may nothing ever come between.
Yo, you know you're really not supposed to take it from the head.
Shit started to change, not put that on my mind. I take all the blame, thinking that shorty real. I caught the game, I thought she felt me like Rocky felt Kane.
That shit's a mess. You gotta do that. Even though everybody else is doing it, that's why I
did. Yo, you're not really supposed to do it from the head, you're supposed to do it from the hand, bro.
Forcing his chip that wore my ass like it was Halloween.
I'm good.
Cool,
bro. 90, damn, you cold hearted.
Yeah. 97.3. You're really not supposed to do it from the head, Sauce.
You want it?
What about you?
I'm going. Quiet, he's minimal.
When you go live on your phone, and shit start cutting off.
Everybody in the street,
What's up? MXM Radio, hold up. There's a lot of side talk going on over here with some good knowledge. With some good knowledge. And I had to stop the side conversation and the songs and everything, like, hold up, Les. They're over here trying to hold back information.
No, it's not holding back.
No, I'm saying.
This is the thing.
Yo, you got to feed the people, though.
But the information we was just sharing with, it's kind of like.
It's open information.
It's open information, but anybody can get it.
People too lazy to go.
No, what it is, if you don't understand the process of using it, you're committing.
You're going to jail.
You're going to jail because it's based on private
commerce.
And public.
Exactly.
If you're still can't public, you can't mix private. You can't be trying to do private stuff.
Tell them what you're talking about.
Uh-huh. You ever heard somebody say when they leave in the Senate, you ever heard this say, I'm retiring and going back to the private sector? Mm-hmm. Y'all heard that a lot when these politicians? Because that means I'm taking my black ass or my white ass from the front of this camera and all this
and public
scenery. And I'm going back
leave
to private.
Leave me the fuck alone.
So I don't have to tell you how much I make, what I make. You can't tax my money. You can't do nothing.
Word? See y'all no, later. Right, no. Because this is what it is. I'm Think private. About this.
knowledge. How many people? Knowledge.
You can look up most people. If you give somebody's name, you can find information
salary,
on people.
Salary, yeah.
But
your
if
records.
You look at somebody who's private and try to look them up, you can't find anything.
Because they said they so name has been
in the way you, the go way go we're supposed to sector. Exist, uh-huh. The way we're supposed to move
is republic.
Is republic the private? Mm-hmm. They got us. They got people in the public because they need them so as great. Commodities. Commerce. Because they took silver and gold out of circulation, which would pay everything, so you would never have debt.
Okay.
So the reason people have debt is because
you were given some legal tender to pass around the United States.
Yeah, you're not paying
your
debt.
You can use this right here.
You're recycling
it, right.
Debt.
Hold on.
You can take this little legal tender, walk around the country.
Is that a little piece of paper? Like, a transcript that nobody else got?
No, everybody got it, but people don't read. What it is the Federal Reserve, no, this is why, when he walked in, we started. He said, your man Trump, he lost. He's contesting it, yet people don't understand the republic
for which it
is the people. Okay. That means everybody in this room is the government. Mm-hmm. And we're telling them what to do. They turned it around. So if you think about the movie V for Vendetta, when he said the people are not supposed to fear the government, the government's supposed to fear the people.
Right.
They turned it around. So what has happened,
they got bigger
they got everybody believing that Europeans started a government. Mm-hmm. There was a government here. Your ancestors, our ancestors,
here.
Were here.
First of all, who are they making treaties with? Y'all hear about all these treaties and all this. They came when Christopher Columbus came over. We're gonna take the
simplest thing.
When he came over here, he seen somebody, right, y'all?
Did he land?
No, he didn't come America. He was in Jamaica and all.
He was on the first place he landed was El Hispanol.
Yeah, he was down south.
Okay.
Then he went to Cuba. Actually, what I'm going to do, y'all going to give me your emails. I got his journal.
Yeah. Oh. Going up the road.
Oh. When he went to Cuba, not Cuba, Cuba, mm-hmm. like you said, you know, all these letters weren't used. Cuba. Mm-hmm. As he was coming up to the shore on the hillside in his journal, he saw a mosque.
Yep. Mm.
He was afraid to get off the ship. Because most people don't know, 1942 was the end of the war between Christians and Moors, Muslims. They took over the last stronghold of our ancestors, the Moors. Yeah, so when Christopher Colón went out on his voyage, okay. You don't have to be a Muslim. Moors just means
the black skin.
It means Mauritania.
You can study the science of Christianity.
Mm-hmm. You can study the science of Islam. You can study all of it is science. But what I'm saying is, when Christoph Colón landed on Cuba, he was afraid to get off the ship because he saw the mosque.
And he already knew.
Do they know?
He already seen the five star.
He's like, do they know that we conquered? So he sent his two navigators, who were Moors,
black boys,
to go speak to the chief, and they were speaking Arabic. Mm-hmm. Now this is in his journal. So wait a minute.
Question again: where English came from? Then?
Oh, English is a fabrication. It's a eugenic system from the ancient languages that our ancestors used.
Mm. Now imagine if we didn't get tricked in all this bamboozle stuff, you know. Imagine where we'd be at right now.
So what's our original language?
God. Vibration. Because you got to remember, we didn't speak.
Right.
We were vibrational.
We got telepathy. We had all that type of stuff going on. Somebody
hit me, like when I spoke about this the first time, I told people that the same way they talk about using the Force in Star Wars is what we're supposed to do. And this cat was like, I don't understand religion. No, I don't, because religion means that's the study of the stars and the moon. But my point is, if you watch that movie, The Last King Kong they made, when they showed the two planes crashed on that supposedly deserted island, and the inhabitants, if you look at the inhabitants, they were melanated. Mm-hmm. But they didn't talk.
They didn't touch on that.
They didn't talk.
They didn't touch on that.
They Right. Use telepathy.
Right, they was looking
because we were vibrational, because we were in harmony with everything. Because
it's not meant for us to talk, man. Head up, mouth closed at all times.
It's about embracing the spiritual the vibration. The vibrations that we transmit to each other. And this group didn't have to talk, and they were... Yeah, that's so powerful.
That's so real, right? Because when our team is really in focus together, our conversations be like, yo, get out my head, because I was just about to say that.
Give a nod, like.
That's a fact, though.
That's a fact. Yo, how many times we said that with each other? Yo, hold on, I was just about to say that.
Right. Yo, get out my head. Because you was just about to say that.
That's the connection. But check it out. What opens that vessel? To allow the spirits to build. We'll get back at this.
We're gonna get back at y'all, man. Say this MXM right now.
Knowledge being dropped tonight, y'all. Knowledge is a special guest tonight.
Lights, camera, action, everybody taking pictures. Now I'm twisting
podcast now, so. What you live on? Radio show?
Yeah, radio
show. Radio show? Broadcast from radio show?
Say my name, say my name. Sounds so good, let me hear it again.
something like that. It's like that, it's like that. Jumping out the Beamer, 360s in the waves. They jumping out the season, I should own me like she was a dancer. Yeah, that's fat, it look like she wearing Pampers. You know I'm from Brooklyn, I ain't with the clown shit. And I get snow, I'm on some in and out of town shit. Yeah, I sip rolls, but tonight I'm on some brown shit. Take a couple shots, knock you out your socks. Hold on, about that mess, and you know that. With 100 grams, I just wanna ask you, owe back. Pay it as you owe that, show it, then you blow that. But now I don't even smoke it. Roll that, pull something like that. It's like that, it's like that. Pull something like that. It's like that, it's like that. Pull something like that. It's like that, like that. Pull something like that.
Oh, Chris chimed in.
Yo.
Tell Chris what up.
MXM Radio. Chris, what up? Shout out to Chris.
I think this is time for...
Thoughts from the back row?
Thoughts from the back row.
What's the movie this week?
This week we running with Creed 2.
Creed 2,
What y'all think about that one?
When you talking about Creed, all I think about is Max's.
Thoughts from the back row. Let's get into it. Creed Part 2.
I'm loving the way they spun off of Rocky with this Apollo.
You can't talk about Creed Part 2 without talking Rocky 4.
Yeah, that's what I said. They spun it off crazily.
And to be honest with you, I've only seen two Rocky movies in the movie theaters.
Right. Mm.
Rocky IV and Creed II.
Okay.
I was 12 years old. My father took me to see Rocky IV with about four friends.
Yeah.
For my 12th birthday, 1985. For my 12th
birthday. For my 12th birthday. Really,
for my 12th birthday.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? But that was the first... My first encounter of Rocky.
So how did you feel with Drago's son now when you watched
honestly,
the sequel? Because his son was a beast.
I was dying to see it.
His son was a beast.
But I'm going to tell you what threw me off real quick. How they fought so fast. Right? Because I was like, wait, hold on. He going to beat his ass already? Like, he going to move his ass quick already? Like, hold on.
End of the movie already? I thought that was the end of the movie.
But you got to remember, right? And a lot of people would disagree with me on this. Rocky, the movie, was a love story.
Yeah.
It turned into a boxer film.
Right.
Yeah. So, when he whooped his ass, that was just the big... Like, they could have broke that up into two movies. Just my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
But the way the attention span of the youngest
nowadays, you gotta put it
in one movie. And it was genius. To me, it was genius.
I love it.
As far as the Drago thing and... My first interaction with Rocky being Big Drago, and then him going to the desert, because Rocky went to the cold, to Russia.
The cold,
I was feeling all of that, dog. They got, two thumbs up in my... The only thing I didn't like about the movie was the fake pregnancy. Because that belly was fake. She didn't have no big titties.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Anybody that been with a woman that had a baby, when she pull out, when the baby's out, that's it, when she pull out. When the baby's out.
That's the reason why she had to pick me out, because you didn't pull out.
When the baby's out, you got stretch marks, you got swollen titties.
That
she looked like she
baby.
Just stepped off the love boat.
That was cinnamon baby.
I ain't mad at her. But that was just a minor detail.
Shout out to Philly.
The fighting in the desert. Like, don't let me... I'll talk forever, but I love this movie, though. So I'll talk forever.
When you talk about that movie, I just want to go to Philly to get a cheesesteak.
No, I want to go to the desert where that dude fought, where he trained at.
I just want to go to matches, man.
And I'm gonna tell you some shit.
You get a cheesesteak.
That reminded me of some DHW shit, I ain't gonna lie. When they stepped in the ring, when they had the tire, and you had to step in the tire, and you just had to bang
until somebody stepped
out the tire.
Uh-huh.
That reminded me of the Terror Dome.
Okay. So, training camp.
I love that movie, though. I love that movie, though.
Yeah, we train different than a lot of people.
I love that movie. Anybody takes, because I talk about Rocky IV and Creed 2.
Nah, I love that movie. Yeah, that's one of my all-time favorites. I'm glad they kept it black, though.
Yeah. And I'm going to tell you something.
Because I've been Italian, you know, I've been rooting for the Italians the whole Rocky.
Rocco!
All the Italians came out of that movie over their nuts, man.
But you already know, since you already know the science. The Italians are black children.
Yeah, they black. They know.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Vin and the rest of everybody. Yeah.
Speaking of that, and it's funny because I was watching a movie. It was about a piano player, and he had the Italian driver.
Oh, you talking about the green?
The green something. Green book. I watched that last night.
Yeah.
And
it's supposed to be a true
story. He said, "Yo, listen." He said, "I'm more blacker than you."
Yeah.
And the dude, like, what you mean?
Yeah.
He said, "Stop the car."
Mm-hmm.
Stop the car.
What was it? Because I'm gonna go look at it.
The Green Book.
It's called the Green Book. It was starring. It's starring the brother that. It's the Muslim brother. I forget his name. He won an Academy Award for a supporting actor.
Yeah.
His last name is Ali. And the cat who was the driver was, if you ever watched the movie called Eastern Promises, he was a Russian gangster.
Mm-hmm.
Yet, he in this movie, The Green Book, the melanated brother was a pianist.
Okay. That was nice.
In the 40s or 50s. And because of, you know, the
culture.
The
discriminatory practices put in place
mm-hmm.
to keep us from ascending, even though we mastered it all. He had an Italian driver who was like a street fighter, always getting into trouble. And the guy was like, basically the Italian driver was like, if I stay out here on the streets, I'm going to die. So I might as well drive this cat and go
make that money.
And yeah, he basically
goes to a lot of shit.
Green Book.
He goes through a lot of shit.
So, okay. Just like.
He goes through a lot of shit, bro.
Homie from Georgia came up and gave us the assignment for Top Boy. Green Book is the movie of the week next week. So that's, thank you, Malik. That's our assignment.
Yeah.
Green Book next week. We're going to look into it. And, you know. But if anybody can go check out Creed 2, you know.
Please.
I know there's a lot of people that don't know what I'm talking about. Rocky 4. Go check it out, and then you'll understand what Creed 2 is about. Bottom line. You know what I'm saying? Let's love.
Let me hear something, Les.
You feel me? Let's Love is
Let's Love in the building. Yo, Mecca, you quiet over there, Mecca.
Chilling out.
You know what I'm saying? The Ravens is still in it, baby.
Sometimes.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't there yet. Shout out to B-Mo.
He need his quarterback.
You got to be more careful right now. Can't talk about the Ravens too much.
Let's do it. Sometimes I got some shit on my chest.
Mecca, get invested, y'all. Get invested.
I know how to get it off without going to jail.
Woo!
Soft. No touch, hit me.
No
cap. MXM for life, I see him lurking. Starring combos in third person, but they virgins. I network like 300 Persians. Never Persians, just found my floor. Began to work it. So my mind powers, cry hours till they talking merging. Even then, I ain't fucking with them till they talking cursing. I put my pain in these verses. Why should I be worthless?
Why?
Ain't enough champagne to drown the strains I'm cursed with.
So it's always like this beat, huh? What do you think this?
Face with the reaper, tow it up in the back. Best believe when I proceed, I can season the vets.
If you're on
brain freeze, say they can't leave it. Cause that I usually ain't gotta like me, bro. But the team you respect, you don't want us on your set. Paintballing with tests. That red don't come off. Two M's and an X. My niggas got the right now.
Motherfucking
come in and tell them that Sean said it. Cause I wanna contest. Much respect to his son, but I'm the last one left. Keep my money like my business, assets and
checks.
When I pass, cash out was next.
Don't
stop the beast, just trying to eat, not to buy, but a piece. Just so I'm ready to say please, not to turn into beast. I suggest you break bread or fill a bread and skip. Word on the street, it's out of turn, we ain't being discreet. Yeah, well earned, motherfucker, feel the burn of these beats. Feel that hot to the boardroom. Four goons, spend time with the fam. We about to go on tour, so it's
36,000.
No,
3600. Speakers.
Yeah,
but I gotta get on the show. I'll put up.
You want to do this interview right here?
Wow.
I'll play this one. Law.
Say something. MXM Radio, we here 8 to 10.
Every Saturday. Tune in.
We're gonna get into some music, but I've just been informed that we got an exclusive interview.
Okay.
Not right now, Les. So keep, you know, we're gonna get into some music right now. But
Sauce, hold on, Sauce. What's the web on the channel? The YouTube channel?
MXM Radio the Show.
Yeah.
YouTube channel.
Both let's start right here.
Share
like
a couple
beers.
My life feels like that sometimes.
Stressful.
Why? Cause I'm cruising while I'm sipping, cruising while I'm sipping. The lights, my town, man, ain't nothing different. Cruising while I'm sipping, cruising while I'm sipping. The noise, my boys, man, ain't nothing different. Boozing while I'm shifting, boozing while I'm shifting. Hey, yo, it's Joe. Yes, yeah, Mr. Chris. Christian, cruising while I'm sipping. Cruising while I'm sipping, and oh, yeah, ain't nothing different. I rip a bogey, watch the smoke pedaling. Lean on the mic, yeah, feel the dough settling. Live off adrenaline, rock a red letterman. Back to the future, baby, I get stupid crazy. Mama Duke, she raised me to get super wavy. Saber blue like I'm Luke till the troopers raid me. What up, everyone? Yeah, I'm from the very sun. Watching belly in my room and smelly cause the cherry's done. In this quiet town, I ride around with a beer crack. See the poem in the heart of town. In the back, I keep a 30 rack slide around, trying to find a lighter because I'm dying to light a pound. And if I don't, I'll turn this motherfucker right around. I love the sights and sounds, I live my life in loud. I give you quite the pound.
Ain't
nothing different, baby, cruising while I'm sick. Cause
I'm cruising while I'm sick.
Cruising while I'm sick. Cruising while I'm sick. Cruising while I'm sick. Man, ain't nothing different. Cruising while I'm sick. Cruising while I'm sick. The noise, my boys, man, ain't nothing different.
You gonna share this
with me? Mr. Christian, cruising while I'm sipping. Cruising while I'm sipping.
I'm going to take you from being worried.
14
minutes. Look, I ain't gotta play all of it. Unless you wanna run. The only way I'm losing now is if they make a clone. I can't get my own, it's only right I take the throne. And I'm on the road to riches, I'm about to take it home. Look, I'm heading straight for the top. Feel like I'm levitating.
Well, I'm gonna get into his last name. A lot of
people, so I expect the hating on the moon. Like a fusion, if got no time for wasting. Only money on my GPS.
All our last names, really. It's like Muhammad with all of these coming here, all the Patels, and bring the ass over here. All the fucking niggas that attack me, that last name, like you really supposed to be. Really supposed to hold on to that shit, that's your title, that's your deity, that's everything. And I'm about to explain it when I get on this microphone.
No, you gotta finish. Before you get into that, you gotta finish to find out what you're saying. Because we got cut off. Come on, man. You're gonna get
You're gonna have to come up.
I was one of those that did talk to him. Then I went over here. Then I was over here. Everything then I read, you got a piece. So then I learned, oh, I can do this.
You got to remember. You got to be real.
Thank God, man. We got to get off that person.
Real.
Yo, when I, watch this shit. Watch how I'm going to set it off, though. Watch how I'm going to set it off, though, because they know who we are. This my hands got his name right here. I'm about to elaborate on it. The Bay, the Day, that's why niggas call Queen Bay and all that. Beyonce, they don't even know what she's saying. She's claiming her royalty. She's telling y'all who she is.
Professor who she is.
I'm Queen Bay. Bay means I'm the royalty.
She's speaking into me, into existence.
They know who you is, man. You don't know.
And you notice nobody has ever challenged when she said I'm Queen Bay.
No.
So when you say who you are, if they want to take that from you, they have to dispute that. Meaning they have to say, no, I have facts that you're not.
And they
so when you say I am God, you have to prove that I'm just God. Because I can show you where Supreme Court
is at.
But to check it out, this is how you bob off Jim Elside and Lee Bassett. They words against you. Supreme Court ruled the word, the Bible is the word of God. And the Bible says, let us make man in our image.
Yep.
I have facts that some of me I am, some of me I'm not.
I got his breath in me, all that.
And his breath is the spirit.
You're the only one that got the divine breath on his brain, man. That's the crazy shit. It's about to go down, though.
Listen, sometimes you gotta be funny.
I'm ready, so let's get it.
Oh, boy.
They got Brother Lucio.
Somebody, the Bantu, I see Aaron. Man, that's just a culture. People, they all the same. That's all luck.
I'm gonna ask you that. I pronounce it right.
Different tribes and nationalities.
I pronounce it right.
Yeah.
I'm playing chess, not checkers, and damn near mastered.
Everything I want, damn near
mastered. You know I'm proud for money in my mind. Know I'm destined to shine. And know it's proud that I got. You know I'm a die for. That's all that I have. So know I'm ready to ride. Everything I want, you know I'm a grind for. Money in my mind. Know I'm destined to shine. And know it's proud that I got. You know I'm a die for.
MXM Radio.
You.
Knowledge is the special guest tonight.
Oh, yes, it
peace
is.
Peace, peace to God.
Peace to the God.
We got a question from somebody on FB.
I know.
Shout out to Double. You know what I'm saying?
Double.
What about the Banter people? Bantu people.
Just another tribe of us excellent people. You know, a lot of us fought against these white people and Europeans back in the day.
Devils.
Just like the Maroons in Jamaica, you know, certain tribes held it down and they still be able to, you know, survive in this day.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of those tribes. But me and Malik was talking about names and things of that nature before we get back to that money thing.
Let's do it this way. We were discussing our royal titles.
Mm.
Names are for corporations.
There you go.
We have titles.
We have titles. Title of nobility.
Exactly.
There you go. Let me rephrase that so we can speak in real language.
Hit them upside the head.
Right. We all have a title of nobility, y'all. What that means is they know who we are as far as gods. When everybody keeps saying, yo, how can you call yourself this and that? Okay, because we are that. But you have to be recognized, right? And if y'all look up Resolution 75.
Oh, you're going in.
I'm taking it.
Oh, God, you're going in. Peace to the God.
Resolution 75 was something in Congress when they were speaking when somebody actually took the stand and let it be known that they know who we are.
Oh, hold on. I got it on my phone.
And you use the name as Day, Bay, L.
Oh! Peace to the God! Peace to the God!
Those are your titles of nobility. So, when you claiming your status back, we keep talking about this Republican and private and all that. That's part of making yourself private.
Islam, more.
So, I self am Lord and Master. Yeah, we all know that. When y'all get back to claiming your status properly, that we trying to get everybody to do, then everybody will understand that we are sovereign and we are the God.
Well, how can you claim your status?
Well, first, hold with that question, I'm gonna just.
That's what I need to know. How can you claim your status?
The fact that he just. Oh, I'm gonna elaborate.
He got both phones.
The fact that he just brought up Resolution 75.
That's a congressional record.
That's Congress. Again, that means it's once again, hold on, time out. Once again, I had to go back to real talk because now we're talking
that's
real.
That's congressional record. So that
I said
means
Congress, right?
Congressional. Okay. It's on the congressional
They know
record.
Who we are.
They know who you are. This European man went in front of the congressional
Congress
and said,
on record,
we need to recognize and acknowledge these people. And they have the right to reclaim their foremothers and forefathers' titles.
Of nobility.
Now.
Preach.
Talking about treaties a little while ago.
Right.
What nation or what country was the first one to get a treaty with the United States?
The Moors.
Morocco. But it wasn't called Morocco. It was called Mauritania.
Or
Amexum.
Mm-hmm.
So they already know who we are. As long as you continue to say, I'm not knocking it, but you got African American, black, Negro, colored, Puerto Rican, Dominican,
Jamaican.
Asian. Those are all Haitians. Brands.
Exactly.
That's saying you're their property. Mm-hmm. Now, going back to what you asked, how do you reclaim your status? Mm-hmm. You have to, what we just said, they have to disprove. So you can put it in writing. I am who you say you are.
Right.
Born of natural birth or born naturally. Because birth is for a ship. They just remove the I, the E, and put an I. Mm. And you have two witnesses. And you get it notarized.
Oh, bring you. He just, you said something crazy. That
drop us some knowledge, dog. Drop us some knowledge.
Yeah, say that again.
They change. Okay. They're using what's called admiralty and maritime law on the land.
Right.
Which is, that means the land of the water. Ships.
Okay.
You're a vessel.
You're a vessel because all of us, when we were born, or
in
we
water.
Were, when we were forming, we were in our mother's water.
You was traveling
and when
in
you
water.
Came through the birth canal, you came out of water and as a vessel. So that's why they said your birthday. That's when you breached. The birth. That's when you breached the canal.
Because you was born actually
Message.
Some weeks before that.
Exactly. You were born, but the birth is of the certificate that they used to enslave.
The live birth.
The live birth that they used to enslave the
contract.
People.
The contract.
The contract.
There you go.
And that's why when we were
get
saying
to the money.
You get how you get your empire, your estate
back,
you have to control that contract. But what people don't know is you can't use a copy to claim ownership. You have to get the original. And no one has ever been given
you
gonna the
get
original.
That. Nah, you can't get that, though. Let me tell you why y'all can't get that. When that lady came in there, everybody that here, whoever has kids, know I'm not lying. All my baby people, all y'all women that deliver, that little black lady that runs in there with that big old sheet and tell you sign this, you'll never see that sheet again. That's
you got a contract. Yet.
That one that you leave that hospital with is a copy.
Is a copy, which means you have a copy of a product.
That one, yes.
That was.
You have a copy of agreement.
A copy of agreement of a contract.
Yes, you have a copy of agreement.
That was created.
From your
that
mother
says,
and the doctor in the hospital.
That says that they the child is not yours.
Right. We're going to take care
you
of the child.
You gave that child.
To
the state.
That's what you signed.
That's what you signed. That's why ACS can come in and take your child.
But hold on, not just take your child. Hold on.
Yo,
if you're not 18 years old, because this is law, y'all.
Okay.
Y'all go look it up.
Go.
At 18 years old, this is where we get into the Republican Democrat thing, where it's not about Republican Democrat for black and white.
No.
When they say majority and minority, the majority mean all the people that claim their birth certificate
Facts.
At 18 years old.
Facts.
They are now the majority.
And if you
and
have not claimed the control of your birth certificate, you're a minority.
From 18 to 99, you're still
you're not, it doesn't mean your color. It means you are childlike and can't speak
and
for
you
yourself.
And you can't speak for
and
yourself.
And you need a lawyer.
Right.
So that's why you have to go and research and read.
And get your birth certificate.
Get the birth certificate. You got to look. You got to start reading. You got to learn about UCC laws.
When they say jurisdiction, when the people come in and say, oh, we have no
jurisdiction
here.
Right.
We have no jurisdiction here.
Right.
Because that's the reason.
So this is now this goes back to
sovereignty and all that.
Well,
you're born sovereign.
And the group is sovereign.
Right.
But what they've done to make you fearful, they start calling it sovereign citizenship because Europeans are trying to do it. Here on America,
in America
when
right.
Europeans are sovereign over
there.
Europe. even though you're the original European as well. Yet
it's a dangerous game with
it's
knowledge.
It's just a game of information. Yet the thing is this.
They're going to get us shut down, man. These niggas know too much, man.
Listen, y'all. Shout out to everybody that studied my all my knowledge, people, all the guards out there, everybody.
Listen, it's about knowing and stop believing.
Yes, if you, information
error. If you want to remove, if you want to protect yourself, and I use this example and people think it's crazy. Listen to this. Think about this. Jeffrey Epstein was in jail.
Yep.
2 days before he allegedly committed suicide, allegedly committed suicide, he transferred $575 million in cash, I think three or four islands, massive amounts of real estate property, to a trust.
'Cause these are all these people that he got to pay off and make sure they're straight for the rest of their life.
Yeah, but yet, think about it. He transferred all this to the trust, right, and 2 days later, he commits suicide. When you give things to a trust that's constructed the right way,
all the beneficiaries,
it could be sitting right here, but they can't touch it. So that's called diplomatic immunity. Mm-hmm. So being that he was under pressure for this whole
goes back to what I'm saying with our diplomatic immunity. Imagine now that we have these brothers claim their self at the age they're supposed to and get that money of all that interest-bearing bonds in your name.
I got a question.
Or that birth certificate.
From the time you signed that contract, Is building interest?
What?
It's been building interest since the time you spit out the womb.
Yeah, well, this is what
the contract that you guys
right. But this is what they did. This is what they did. Mm. Everybody gets it confused because people believe this landmass we're on is called America. Mm-hmm. How many Americas are there?
Two,
three. Canada's North America now. Because George Bush signed an executive order removing the borders.
Right.
North America, this is now Central America and South America.
Right.
Mexico.
The fuck?
Yeah, he changed it.
Right.
So you don't need a passport to get to Canada no more?
When you're in your proper status, you can travel along this way. Just keep going moving. But going back to what they did,
I know who you are.
Hold on. Let me finish.
Your passport is stronger than your driver's
license. Your passport is your body. I am that I am. So how you can tell me that I can't move on the land of my father?
I can pass the port.
I'm gonna ask you a question that makes sense.
But hold on, let me finish. Let me make this. Let me go back to how you asked is gained interest. 1933, and this is in the congressional records. You can look this up.
Took out the gold.
The United States Corporation, not America, the United States government, which is only Washington, D.C. in a 10-mile radius. Read your Constitution. Mm-hmm. Filed bankruptcy. What files bankruptcy? A business. Mm-hmm. The corporate United States filed bankruptcy in 1933 because they couldn't pay their debts. Mm. They was like, okay, we need money. They borrowed money.
The reason why they couldn't pay the debts. Hold on, we gotta give them the reason why.
Well, because they moved.
Every state had their own money.
Everybody, because every state is its own private nation. Every state is its own nation.
They couldn't govern all this different money from each state, and every private sovereign was bringing to them.
So they had to. They was like, okay, how are we gonna get this? How are we gonna get money? They said, hey, we'll collateralize the people, and they put a number. Every time a child was born, they put like a $650,000 value on each birth certificate.
From the birth.
And it's like a CD or 401k. Longer it sits, the more it gains. Right. That's how it gains value.
Right.
And that's why anytime you go get a job or you ask for an education, they say, give me your social security number. Because they're taking the credit. They're getting paid.
All right, I got something for y'all. Hold up, y'all. All my people out there that ever did banking, this is I'm going to give y'all an easy one. I'm going to give y'all an easy one.
Don't make it
y'all ever, no, real easy, so they can understand what they're doing with
they
public and private.
They don't even understand what they're doing.
Okay, hold on. Public and private, I'm going to give y'all a good one. You ever went to the bank and dealt with a bank? Let's say you overdraft some money and you owe them some money, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, now you tried to go back to that bank, and they say, we've discharged this debt. Right?
you hit
we can't We can't give you a bank account anymore. You got to go somewhere else. Let me tell you why. When you discharge a debt, that technically means I went to your private side and took that money. I can't mix public and private because the law states.
Because then you can open the books and see that they got paid.
They got paid, right.
If you got paid, then it's just some more money for me.
No. Hold on now. Not just that. They know you don't control that account yet.
Exactly.
See, that's why they say you can't open up another account here because it's now zeroed out for real.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you?
We went over your head.
You got to go to another bank and open up another bank account.
Right.
And once you discharge a debt, you cannot reissue that instrument.
Right. So they because it's already paid. It's satisfied.
Right. Now, no, it's really satisfied now. See, when they call in the creditors and they selling it. So yeah, it's still circulating.
Now, check it out.
Once you debt it, you can't sell it.
Now, check it out. You already went somewhere with that. This is for people who always get scared when you get these notices in the mail from a collection agency.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Me and Malik, we sitting here. We have an agreement between us. I owe Malik $5,000. Yep. I don't pay Malik. You buy the contract.
Bought the debt.
Me and Malik has an agreement. You bought the contract. So you paid Malik.
Mm-hmm.
You come see me. Do I owe you?
No.
Why not?
Because I paid Malik for the contract.
So that means anytime
you still owe him though.
But the thing is, whenever you get something from a collection agency, you don't have a contract with them.
Mm-hmm.
All you gotta do is ask them to produce the original wet ink agreement between you and that party, and you give them 7 days.
They can't produce that.
They can't produce it, so then they're gonna be like, okay, this is satisfied, discharged.
Mm-hmm.
It was already paid.
It was paid because you bought it. So now let's go. Now tell me if I'm wrong with this. Let's go. Okay, go ahead. Ask the question.
My question is, how can you get?
You got to be careful. Money.
What you want?
How could you get your birth certificate if you didn't get it, like he said, at 18? Is it too late?
Okay, no, it's never too late.
So all that interest is still on?
Let me set it up.
I mean, somebody say something.
All right, here we go. I'm going to start the process. All right, first the process is start a little bit. You have to get your original birth certificate, y'all, okay? Get that stuff notarized. It's a few things you got to do.
Okay.
Go to where you were born, the county.
The county clerk.
Hold your record.
County is the one that is
that's
using,
your address, really.
That is the county is actually acting your as
address.
Your trust.
Yes.
Your address.
That's where you live.
And that's where you're supposed to already say what's your address.
That's really our address.
You're supposed to write where your birth certificate is
at. Right.
Not where you sleep.
Reside at. Right.
No one's supposed to ever know where you sleep and knock on your door.
Nope. Never. That's why some people have P.O. boxes on their address.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
You're not supposed to. I had that for a while.
You're supposed to be.
Going. Your corporation.
He's the underground king right now.
He just
came back.
Listen, you want to know something? This goes to show you.
This nigga.
How the universe works. And how the creator is bringing elements together.
We need this.
I never would have been up here if it wasn't for Less Love. Yet, Less Love brought me up because I did a TV show back in 2010 in Manhattan on public access television. And I was a little bit more radical. I was like talking. Yet, my point is, the first time we met, you said, "Yo, I already got my birth certificate, so you already,
I already clicked. Yeah, I knew who you was going with.
I wasn't here 2 weeks. I wasn't here last week, and I wasn't here 2 weeks ago. I wasn't going to stay. We're supposed to be here.
Yeah, my man said, "Yo, today's the day." I said, "Okay." He said, "You know
we're
what?
supposed to be here. We're supposed to be here to give the people the information that they need to be free. Because Kanye West said it best, but people don't like it. Slavery is a choice."
Right now it is.
It's a choice.
Back then it wasn't.
Even back then it was to the point because the information was there. Just that our ancestors was fearful.
We was here.
That's it. But it's a choice. The choice wasn't made. The conditions put in front of us made us feel that we can't go that way because we from way over there when you were already home.
Right.
Now, going back to what we said about the birth certificate, like the guy said, mm-hmm. you have to order.
Get it authenticated.
You got to get it. You got to order it. If you go down to the Department of Vital Records, so many people are doing it. The gatekeepers are going to jam you up.
You got to know what to do, how to move.
You got to know to do it without a lot of resistance. Right now, you can go online and go to VitaCheck, and you order what's called the long form.
But
the
any certified copy is now they accept.
Yeah, they accept it. Yeah. You can get what's called the long form, and
that's
you order it
to the original.
And what they ask you is, what do you want it for? Right. And they have the wording, apostille or authentication. You want it, you order the long form. They're going to send it to you with a cover letter from the city. Mm-hmm. Then you take it down to the county.
Albany, yep.
You can take it to, like you said, whatever county you were born on. You was born on Westchester, you was born on the Bronx. You take it down to the county. You ask them to authenticate that the city's notary is in good standing.
Copy. That's right.
Then once you do that, you got to take it down to 123 William Street if you're on New York City. When you take it to 123 William Street, this is when they trick you and jam you up.
Right.
Because you got to fill out a form, and they're asking you, what do you want it for? You want it to travel. Mm-hmm. You have to pick what's called a non-Hague country.
Non-Hague. But let me tell you, even further than that, with the Hague, it goes a little even deeper before that part right there.
What's a non-Hague country?
Hague is
this shit
Hague.
Is so deep, man. You can't just jump around. You got to stick.
Part
stick
of the Hague is a country that won't extradite your ass. If you do something in the country, won't send you back here.
Facts.
So you need an address like Jamaica. Mm. I can use Jamaica, but a lot of people use Hong Kong and all that. But use some way you know if you really.
No extradition in Jamaica?
No. Why?
I go.
Or even Cuba.
Yeah, Cuba. You can do.
Why
Cuba.
Why you think Asada Shakur is still on Cuba?
Right.
And guess who was the main one trying to go get her?
Obama.
Thank you. I was waiting to see. Obama.
Know.
The one that everybody thought was going to work for the people was the main one trying to go get Asada Shakur.
We're going to get into some MXM music, y'all. We're going to get back in depth. We got another 30 minutes. It's the guard hour.
It's time for the Less Love takeover.
Let's get it, baby.
We almost forgot about that. Let's do it, Les.
Yeah, you got to be careful with this. You can't go get the private money and put in the public bank account. They want you to do that.
They did that. I said, okay, I know the bank, I know the route, So boom, I called it, the bank straight, right? I took out $1,000. Now my homeboy told me I didn't take out enough. And he said I should have asked the balance. He said, because those accounts usually daily withdrawal to $250,000.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I supposed to have shook out about $300.
Because all that is credit.
Right.
It's unlimited.
Oh, it's all your. No, but it's a limit on it because
per day.
When I looked at how much mine was, my personal account was like at $60 million. Woo! My daughter
when
was 4 years.
How long ago was that?
That was like 3 years ago.
So now look at the interest that was accumulating.
Right. Now
it's up there.
But see me? I was playing by myself, so I was going in. I wanted to put the brakes. I'm like, you know what I'm saying?
He was on that.
I'm in there. Yeah, right. You feel me?
Stick your toe in the water.
Yeah,
because
I'm like,
in the heat.
But once I found out what it was real, the dude was like, is there anything else I can help you with, Mr. Roberts? I was like, that's it. I went straight to the ATM. $1,000 right there. Can I take it out, though?
Yeah.
She shot it out the machine. I looked around, make sure no police. I went home. I'm chilling, no police come, no phone calls. No thing from the bank saying illegal transport, nothing.
Right, like, what you gotta remember, what we gotta take into consideration. When it's on the private side, that's silver and gold.
Right.
When it's transferred to the Federal Reserve, that's public. That's why you have to have that trust bank account.
I'm gonna show you now with that. Fidelity got Yo, told me I had to set up, and I did. I set up a money management account and a brokerage account.
You already went there.
You know what I'm saying? So you already know, like, I traded it that way.
You have to wire it through. You have to go through the various channels.
But now I'm at the point where I don't even want none of that shit. What's going on?
They're not going to give it to you.
No, I'm fucking
it
up.
But you got to be careful, because you know if you got gold, you're going to take it. No, when you go to buy something, nobody's gonna be able to take it. That's why
I'm gonna give the credit now.
I'm gonna give the credit.
I'm the credit.
You're making yourself the bank.
Right. Once you take over your what's name, you are the bank. Now.
Right.
You're so if I got
gold. I got you. Say no more. I already know where you're going.
Over. Yeah. So let them come.
They can't come. They're gonna be like.
This motherfucker.
Please don't tell nobody else. Don't tell the rest of the slaves. You might gotta be careful.
I don't give a fuck.
No. The way they raise your shit, they don't know where to find you.
No, they don't.
So you're good. The average person that says, my address is 115 West 140 Dudley. That's why when they get searched for it, they knock on people's houses.
Unfortunately. I got something for that too. I got the letter post on your door. This is the such and such, you can't come back.
Oh, well, the thing is, like I said, when I get the land is going to be under my foreign trust. And that means if you cross this line, that means you're in the invading army. I can take you out soon if you step 5 feet on my land.
Like, land. You're my country.
You're speaking some knowledge,
that's bro. That's my laws.
Yes, you're right. Yes.
Knowledge was the guest tonight.
Now, I know this shit a little bit.
I know, listen. We got to enforce it. The more we enforce it, the less they can touch you.
Right.
And then what you do is you're bringing more people out, which gives them less control. Because right. They start saying, you gotta create non-taxable entities. The easiest way to do it, go on the IRS website, get an EIN number. You're gonna get an estate number with the EI, with your social. Then once you get that estate number, everything after that you create for right now off the IRS website is a religious or church control. You'll get a non-taxable number.
But I got mine right now, okay, with my non-profit, right? All businesses. After that 13, if it's a 4-1 after it, that's a foreign trust. So now, no taxes, I ain't involved with the government. That's why I put everything.
Matter of fact, I'm gonna bring all my shit, because I was studying all last night, and I was studying today. And what I was also doing, Dun & Brad. Get Dun & Brad numbers.
Got all that.
Everybody else does.
I'm just saying, let me say
what we gotta do. Get Dun & Brad numbers. Get EIN numbers.
I got 3 emails from that shit we did about the EIN numbers.
I told you.
Right now,
you
gotta answer that shit.
What? What happened?
But they nothing negative. They trying to make me pay. Yeah, we gonna do something with it.
They trying to make me pay for it.
Yeah.
Pay for what?
EIN.
What, on the IRS website?
Yeah. I'm gonna do on this side. I said, hell no, I ain't gonna pay.
Now, you know what the email said? You got an incomplete form or whatever. You wanna come back and finish this form?
I'll look at it.
But Dun & Brad numbers everybody should have, because what you think their name is on that birth certificate, you're supposed to change to a business. You get a Dun & Brad number. You use the social to get an estate number, so you don't have to use the social.
That's all.
Okay. Then to really just go invisible and dark is CPA number. CPN number is the number, Social Security number is the CPN number that the corporation created. EIN is another, so you create another number and you start using that and build credit with a total different name.
And like right now, when I do my WA change number,
you create a new title, but you don't attach it to that social.
I'm going
to
attach my L to my
WA
number. Yeah,
Once you do that,
I got a lot of kids fucking with them dudes in the
fence. Yeah, that shit.
When I hear it, I know
what you talking about.
Yeah.
And I sat around. Yeah, you know,
you look on sound exchange, right?
Conversation.
That's how you sound exchange is real. He said you can use your WA VIN number. That means they deal with private entities too.
Ooh.
Sound exchange.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But when I seen it on the application, say your WA VIN number, I said,
oh.
So we got back.
Nigga, listen.
This what you, oh, this is what you want to do. Once you get your trust set up the right way, it has to be foreign. Once you get your foreign trust set up, you get an accountant. They can go back to the time you first started working and get all that money back. Now, you don't want the paper.
Gotta be gold.
You want still want gold.
No, no.
Or,
hold on. Legal
tender. Now, check it out.
Nope. Real money.
Lawful money.
It's words.
Now, I ain't lawful money. Check this out. This is something everybody's probably doing every once a month. Either you write a check or you use money on it, right?
Rent.
Yeah. Where it says memo, all you gotta do is write 12 USC 411.
Wait, say that again.
Where on the check or money order, where it has the line for memo, you can write 12 USC. That means lawful money. That means you're giving lawful money.
Right.
And when you give it to somebody, that means they use that and they transfer, they change it to lawful money.
Yeah, they got real.
That's why you're supposed to use open money on it. Because when you use a postal money, a postal
third
money
party, you need to pay all that.
Pay the rent.
Now, however, they want the money to receive it. It's on the
U.S. Post. Government gives it, like, it's already
what it is. When you use a postal money order and you send it to pay somebody, it satisfies the total debt. But you don't know it.
Even if you pay half?
If you're not paying
half,
you can use a dollar. And you put redeeming lawful money. And you put USC,
yeah. I owe you $500. I get a money order for $1. I put.
He has to be a person first.
Has to be a company.
Has to be a business. Because your all capital name is a company.
But it is coming to a company. Okay. You writing me, I am a company. Malik
right.
Roberts all capital.
Right. It's a
people I pay my rent.
You pay, but the thing
that's
is.
Only, that's only.
No. No, this is the thing. Because you don't have to control of your information.
Straw man.
You can't really do it. You go to jail. Have to set
thing
up.
But see, my thing is this though. No, hold on. All these niggas
hold on. If Wesley didn't fuck up,
no.
Why did he go to jail?
I have no idea.
Because he didn't fill out his form.
All these niggas didn't
because Wesley created a business called Armin Raw Productions that produced the movies. He made a profit.
Well, that's where he fucked up.
He didn't.
By making a profit?
That's what income is.
Income is a profit.
That's what it means. Profits and gains made.
And you have to report.
That's
why you're supposed to do non-profit.
Right.
That's why you're supposed to do non-profit or make your name religious.
That's where that apostille and all that shit coming
exactly.
In your paperwork.
Please.
So they can't tax you.
And you're also supposed to, you know how to do it. Another way you can do it, check it out. If you want, okay, I don't know.
Yeah, I know.
Let's do it like this. If you wanted to, let's say we working together, and I have the bank account set up, and I pay you every week, every 2 weeks. You want to get taxed? You don't want to get taxed.
Nobody wants to get taxed.
I just write on there donation
on my paycheck.
Yeah.
Donation.
Push the donation
button.
Donation.
I thought it was a trash can.
Donation. The thing is, donations are non-taxable. They're up to $50,000. Yet, if the entity that is being sent to is already recorded,
can I ask a question? Sure. Is that why churches are able to operate the way they do?
501c3s, because they take your money.
All that.
They take your money. And say, hey, it's for the church. But the priest goes to buy the Rolls Royce.
But it's just a donation.
But it's a donation.
So you don't have to report
it. You don't have to pay taxes on it. You get the tax right off the inventory.
Exactly.
So, if everybody in the congregation is not smart enough to do the tax write-off, what happens to, is he responsible? Or the congregation?
You don't get your money back.
You ain't getting your money back.
If you have
the congregation,
you don't get your money back. You get that money back. If you know how to write it off.
Okay.
But the priest, or the priest, that's why everybody wants to go into not Christianity.
Church and state is separate.
Church and state is separate. State is what? A nation. Church is
real
your body.
Estate, exactly. Real estate.
This is the real estate.
Right here. This.
So you gotta make the name a religious one. Right.
What they trying to do, all these social security numbers, they're trying to put space in there. They don't know you.
Why do you think they want to stand 6 feet apart? So that facial recognition can not say, okay, we're gonna rewalk. And now they attach it to all the information that's attached to it.
Yeah, they need to.
So now when they okay, let's put this person up. Oh, his name is this. Your social security number is this. So now they say, okay, you belong to us. When you put all that shit under trust,
when you put your name into the system, when you get out of this shit, you gonna go on the list, my nigga.
Do not stop. Do not detain.
Do not detain. That's right. You gonna get on that.
You gonna go on that list.
When they put your name up, when you see them white people jump out the door, motherfucker, you know who I am.
They know that. Or you do it the right way, and you put your car.
One of these rings that I got.
Or you put your car and the plate, and they now when they run your plate, without telling you, that's a violation of your Fourth Amendment
right.
But when they run the plate, and they see that right it's there. Owned by a trust,
well, say do not detain.
They don't. They can't fuck with you.
So isn't that what every cop is doing, running your plate without your license?
Yes, right.
Yeah.
So that's why you want them to. Because you want to get ready?
No.
Illegal.
There's a law called Miranda versus Tresvant.
So you got to name Miranda right.
Miranda was the name of the man that was unlawfully stopped,
right.
And he sued the city of Tampa. It states in this case law, if the police stop you without a warrant, without seeing you have committed a crime, it's called detainment. And it's a chargeable offense that they have to pay. The longer they hold you, the more you get.
Exactly.
But you don't sue the police. You sue the police
insurance company.
And you
go after they bomb.
And you sue the county. So you sue the mayor,
the sheriff, governor, everybody.
And the way it's set up, this cat was held for 22 minutes, and he got $25,000.
$25,000, right? But if he was on that do not detain list, he wouldn't have got stopped.
He wouldn't have got stopped at all. But this is for our people that get stopped now.
Right.
You want them to hold you.
Yeah, you do.
You know what bugs me out? What y'all talking is some real shit. The people that get pulled over and they think they know what they're talking about and really don't know what they're talking about.
You don't
they
want
get
to
25
talk.
To life.
Yeah. You know what? No, seriously. What they do is...
You're not supposed to talk. You don't talk. You're not supposed to say nothing.
This is what you say. Get your chief or your superior officer and get the sheriff. Now, going back to this, the longer they keep and hold you, the more you get. So let's say cats that get caught up and hemmed up from Friday to Monday. You supposed to go back and sue them for $1.8 million. Once you put
paperwork and all your stuff is together.
But that's if you don't. That's if you don't.
Yeah, you can come back later.
But you can always go back and get them. Because you got proof that they violated.
They held you, yes.
And they supposed to pay you. So $1.8 million for 3 days. You want them to hold you. You want them to hold you. But yet, whenever they stop you, say, I don't answer questions.
It's real.
I posted it.
And then
you can say nothing, right? This is my thing. When a cop pulls me over and he starts asking a question, I say, don't I have the right to be inside?
No.
No, that's not
it. But you're asking a question.
Yeah, you
just say, I don't answer questions. Bring your superior and a sheriff here.
What do I do when the sheriff gets there?
You tell the sheriff he is violating your right to travel, your constitutional right to travel.
You have to say it like this. I have the right to road travel. I'm a privately traveling on this road. You only need a license to do commercial business.
Right. You're not getting paid.
I'm not getting paid to drive him. This is just my man.
This is how they jam people up.
With that license.
They pull you, even with this, they pull you over.
Where are we driving today?
Who?
I'm not a driver.
They talking to him. Then they go, who's this? This is my passenger. that's you're paying.
Cargo, right.
You just told him. Oh, you just told him. Okay, I can rob you now.
Exactly.
So what did you say? These are my guests.
Yes.
Okay. It's like you're a guest in my house.
Exactly, you're a guest in my car. Right, and we're traveling. You're not driving.
Nobody's driving. We're traveling because there's no commerce being committed. Now, what you're doing...
You only need a license to drive a bus, to chauffeur somebody, to drive a taxi.
Okay.
The only thing about getting paid...
Yeah, that's what we need. That's what you need to come. That's what you need. That's what you need. Now, the thing is...
See, the other is extra. Right. I'm just saying, the license itself, period. Well, you don't need
but the issue is, like you
said,
you don't need none of that shit. You waive your right to get that license.
I don't have a license. I'm a war.
Yeah, you don't need
it. And he said some shit, that's why the police had to leave him. Like,
that's why you give that, you give everything. You give the birth certificate, the social security card, and that driver's license to your trust. Now, the trust owns it.
That's when you're doing the UCC paper.
Exactly. You do a non-UCC
statement. And only thing the UCC is to make yourself unlienable.
Facts.
So nobody can't come put a lien on your house, nobody can't put...
So what you do is...
You put them on notice.
You put them on notice. This is what you do is, the first what you do is, you go do a DBA.
Your business as...
Last
Daniel
name...
L. No, no. Last name
last name. Last name.
Dorsey.
Because your name Daniel is actually L. your last name.
Last name, yeah.
That's right. Your name.
Your name is Dorsey, not Daniel. Okay.
Last name, comma, first name, middle, doing business as... First, middle, last.
And technically, that ain't your name either.
That's not your name.
It's your grandfather's name.
That's the name that you're lineage.
Yeah.
But what you do, once you do a DBA, then you trademark.
You take that out. That's why the army for you by your last name.
Exactly.
The police for you by
last name. You do a DBA for that address, you can't never take that out.
No, you don't put in no address.
Ain't no address.
You just doing a DBA for the information that they used against you.
Yeah.
That all capital.
Then I'm doing business as police outside your Robert.
You trademark that. And put that on record. Once you put it on the county record and you get that back, you send it to the sheriff.
Yep, put copy, it on notice.
And you send it to the police. This is now trademark and copyright. If you do not have written consent to use this property, that's infringement and injury.
Why is it that somebody like somewhere telling people this information? Like,
oh.
There are a lot of people out there saying, but what is
this? It's just a it's, low key.
It's like this. This is
that's
the best way.
Brother
Rob, I'm gonna put it this way.
I never met you and shit. This is
the best way.
We were kids, and so he got knowledgeable.
That's what happened. Just,
so like, I'm
but on this shit, level, bro. But what y'all on is on this
but
level.
Everybody's
right
supposed
here,
to go up. People want to stay down because company.
Everybody's scared of now.
The best way I can describe it in our time was Babash El Hadji Muniz Shabazz is up, and Dr. Martin Luther King. He's good on both of them. People were afraid of what Malcolm was saying, and they followed Dr. Martin Luther King.
It was easy for them to swallow.
It was easy for them to swallow.
But they were going
2 weeks before Dr. Martin Luther King got assassinated, he said it, it's on record. He told Harry Belafonte,
he was
I fear I'm leading my people into a burning house.
He was, though.
So why would this man say he's fearing he leads his people to burn? Integration was the worst thing that could have
ever.
Biggest to set us back. We went from ownership controlling to being servant to servants and slaves. Baba El Hadji Shabazz was talking. First he was talking about black and white because that's what he was up against. When he traveled and expanded his thought process, not black and white.
The world.
It's about national, about nationality.
Yep.
Why did he change his name to Baba's name El Hadji El Malik Shabazz?
L.
Muhammad Ali.
All of Ali's, El Bay, Day, all that shit is
so
your lineage.
People,
what?
Those are your name, your last name, like when you hear Muhammad in the Indian, all the people that royalty and all the motherfuckers, his name
Muhammad. Yes.
Just like with the Indian, Patel, all the rich motherfuckers, his last name Patel.
Right.
They take on that name, they come over the United States, and same thing with us. Our divine name is El Bay Day, all that. If we use that title, they won't be slaving.
Message. Now, with that, when Baba El Hadji Shabazz came back, he was more knowledgeable. He started talking about nationality. That's why he was talking about taking the United States government, not America, United States government, to court at the UN for international human rights violations.
Yeah.
That's why they had to kill him. because he had 25 African kings that was like, we are with you.
Yep.
We'll stand up with you in court. They was like, oh, no, we can't do it. Now it's connected.
That.
That's why the BOP, the Bureau of Prisons, is a corporation.
Yeah.
Bureau of Prisons, corporation, hospitals, schools, everything.
If you look at their shit, they got the flag on it in the bathroom.
Yeah.
Because they're not the United States of America.
No, right. They're corporations.
We went to trial with the corporation.
That's why you can.
Not the land.
The reason that you, and I don't know what it is, that Social Security number is a product of their corporation.
Exactly.
You didn't take control of it.
Right.
Take control of it. They can't.
I never knew nothing about that.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. Check it out. You can change, you know, you can get them to erase all that shit if you do it, you do things the right way, and you can get them to pay you for violation of the human rights.
All the shit. All of that, isn't it? I know when they bring you to court, you ask the wrong questions the wrong way, you done fucked up.
What you supposed
to do? You only got three answers.
What you supposed to do, right? They bring you in or you go in, which one?
Either way, you go in.
Let's say they have you, ask you to come in. First and foremost, if you have your shit set up the right way, they won't even want you to come in court.
Yes. I am the authorized.
I am the holder of due course.
You are. And what you
have done. I am the authorized. I am the holder of due course. And I only control the property. Now, when you set it up the right way, it's an equity court. It's not in the regular court.
Whole jurisdiction.
Whole different jurisdiction. So they're not going to want to bring you into a regular court. Because now you're going to expose everything.
And that's going to let everybody else know they want. Sorry to fuck with you.
Yo, bro.
But if you got to go to court, the equity court, they got to prove that they have control over your property.
Let me tell you how scared they were when they took me to court. Okay. Not right
now.
Eight minutes.
Okay,
go ahead. Eight minutes. Yo, MXM Radio, y'all. What's good?
MXM Radio.
It's Mook here. Peace. Mecca. Lesson.
Knowledge was the guest tonight,
knowledge,
ladies
y'all.
And gentlemen.
Knowledge is
the key. Malik peace. And Malik. Let's get a round of applause.
Yo, Malik, peace to the gods. Peace to the gods. Peace to the gods and the goddesses.
If you didn't catch it live, tune in. What's the YouTube channel?
YouTube channel is MXM Radio Show.
Yo, I want to shout out my brother, Blue Lodge.
MXM Radio.
American Free Lodge.
Okay.
Shout out to the gods.
Okay.
St. Joseph
peace
Grand
to
Lodge.
Gods, peace to the gods. I want to shout out one person that I can say that has shown the path to really be private, and that's the god, Jonah Bay, down on Atlanta.
Go ahead, Joe. He's from Yonkers. Yeah, yes. Jonah the God. He came down to Georgia, and he put the spanking on him down there.
Yes.
Okay. He showed what happened when you lock up a nigga that really know his stuff.
Okay.
When they locked him up and they was playing them ghetto games with him.
Okay.
He came back out with the blueprint.
Yeah, I think we should be on the birth of a new show, y'all. Malik versus Malik, or Malik and Malik.
King of Kings show. We got.
King, how you say it again?
King of Kings.
King of Kings. Okay.
There you go.
We just going to work out the time slot.
Yeah,
and I rest
together.
Assure you, these brothers will be back kicking the knowledge that you heard tonight. All right?
Let's do it.
Are you all on? Are you on board, Malik?
I'm on board.
Are you on board, Malik?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. It's Malik and Malik. King of Kings.
Peace, love, light, and harmony to all the
shout
people.
Shout out to
power
all
to
the
all
gods.
The
gods. Got it. MXM Radio, y'all.
Yo, we appreciate y'all coming out,
man. Tune in next week,
man.
8 to 10, Saturdays.
MXM Radio.
We got a special, serious situation going on next week. I'm not even going to tell y'all about it. Y'all got to just...
tune in.
Just log on to social media. It's going to be everywhere. You know what I'm saying? The team is fully assembled back. So we're going to do what we got to do. Everybody going to push the button they got to push it. We see y'all next week, man. MXM Radio from the team. Full MXM Radio staff. We love y'all, and... let's do it.
We out of here.
Peace.
Yo, roll up, E. You know what it is, man.
Okay.
It was a wild minute.
If
y'all
they
like
ever
once again, 420.
You have
420. We did it again, baby.
This time around, y'all.
No higher lawyer.
He's on
18.
What you
unless
sure
you
do,
know how to work.
Well, what you do if you hire sure you get him to say,
he's spinning
him. Make sure this shit is correct.
That's what I'm
talking about. But what you do,
whatever you're trying to do, you see. in your studio, baby. I'm trying to get it. I am in this fit. And
after the game, point by point by point. But don't send it to the office of the clerk.
No, you send it to the judge.
To the office of the judge.
You send it to the judge.
Yeah, they got two different offices. Everybody always